Hello friends, welcome to part 2 of problem solving stage of your startup in this program called Build Your Startup with Nischal Kapadia on channel Haiku. So in the previous session, what I discussed or what I shared was about how do you identify what problem you are about to solve and what should be your considerations while you are identifying this problem or when you are building a problem statement. In this session, what we will discuss or what I will share is what is it that you need to think of when you are drafting your solution to the problem statement that you have identified. Some key parameters which will help you to really think through as to what and how should your solution look like. Okay, so here we go. Point number one, do you have some such insights into that particular problem that you are trying to solve? Understand, there are a lot of people who are like you, who are intelligent and trying to address the same problem in a different way, right? So it's not that you may or may not be unique, right? It can be a possibility. So when you're doing that, is there something that you understand far better than others of that particular problem that you can really give a better solution as compared to others? Think about this. You may not want to be in a situation where you work on something, you create a solution for something, spend your time, energy, money, and then you find somebody has already kind of, you know, worked on a solution which is far better. You don't want to be in that state. So understand, do you have some real insights into solving that particular problem? Most important. Next, are you trying to solve a problem which is connected to the entire chain, or you are solving a piece of it? Now understand, both have its own relevance and both can be products in itself. I'll give you an example. The ticketing world that we are seeing, from flight tickets to bus tickets, train tickets, or even movie tickets, right? Book My Show and all of that. Now, in the initial days, what they solved was the booking part of it. If you were booking a ticket on, say, a Book My Show, which is a movie ticket booking platform, you would have to book your tickets on the platform, but still collect the physical tickets at the theater, right? So they were solving half part of the problem, which is still fair. It is now that there is everything available on E and you can just show your E ticket and still move into the movie theater. But in the initial days, if you remember, it was just 50% of the problem being solved, right? So think about this. What are you doing? And again, both can be products in itself. Things evolve. Maybe you will have a complete solution later. But as of now, even if it's a part solution, it is fine, right? But you should know what exactly are you trying to do or what solution you have. Is it addressing the entire chain or is it addressing the part of it? Okay. Next. Is it the solution that you have come up with? Is it more expensive, more laborious than what the current solution is? You may feel that you have created a superior solution to what you are giving to your audience. But is it more laborious? Think about this. Does it require more manpower? Does it require more resources in terms of money? Does it require more resources in terms of the infrastructure? It does happen. It does so happen that while you are building a solution, while building you feel it's easy, it's an easier way to solve a problem. But for the audience who is going to consume it, it may turn out to be a bigger problem. Right? Very important. For example, when a Google Drive is solving a problem of data transfer. Now, assuming Google expects you to create a different ID, a different machine, or different infrastructure for that, it charges a huge fee for the transfer. Think about all of this. If all these things are kind of created as hurdles, then the adoption would become much difficult, because you will say, okay, I have a pen drive already. I'll just quickly transfer this data from my machine to the other person's machine. What happens? I will waste half an hour, 1 hour. That's okay. But if you eliminate these hurdles, the adoption will go much higher. So remember this, the solution that you're providing has to ease the challenge that the consumer is facing and not increase the challenges the consumer is facing. If you have got this kind of a solution, go for it. So with this, we have seen the problem part of it. How do you go about solving a problem? and the solution when you are building, how should you think whilst building that solution. So with this, I hope that you create a beautiful product with a superior solution which will be adopted by your audience much, much faster. All the best. Thank you.